But let's take an overview first from Warwick Lightfoot, who has served as advisor, special advisor to three chancellors, Nigel Lawson, John Major and Norman Lamont. He's head of economics and social policy at the Policy Exchange and joins me now. From what you've heard, from what's been leaked, what do you think might work? What do you have concerns over? Good morning to you.
Morning. First of all, Policy Exchange has given a lot of thought to this. We've produced a paper, Pro-Growth Economic Strategy, and another one, arguing why government should spend more on capital and infrastructure. And I'm hoping that many of the sorts of things that have sort of been suggested, like the green investment in insulating homes and so on, the things that employ a lot of people can be brought forward and financed by government to stimulate employment. I think special employment measures, before I worked at the Treasury, I used to work at the Department of Employment in the 1980s with those very high levels of unemployment. And I think that we're going to have to be very careful to construct training programs that help someone changing jobs to give them the help they're going to need to get a job where they won't necessarily be job ready immediately. And it's going to take the government time to get that right. In the 1980s, we never really got that right. And I think one's got to proceed on with an open mind on this. But the big thing I would say to the Chancellor, and we've said it in our papers, the constraints of high interest rates and high inflation are not present. When I was in government 30 and 35 years ago, we were very constrained by high and erratic inflation and high interest rates. The government can now borrow and use its balance sheet when it needs to do this. And they can cut taxes and they can afford to use active fiscal measures to stimulate the economy. And they should use the instrument of borrowing to pay for it.
What cured the United Kingdom, Great Britain, from the malaise of the 80s ultimately?
It took a very long time. It was a very deep economic shock. And if you remember, in the 1980s, the core of it was a labour market that didn't work because you had trade union power that was too great, so that wages and employment never adjusted to a shock, made much worse by a long overhang of structural impediments from industries that hadn't really been sorted out, some of them going back to the Industrial Revolution, to the post-war period. And also, we had got ourselves into a high, relatively high level of inflation that destroyed our international competitiveness that eventually had to be dealt with. And there was no easy way around disinflating your economy. So you had these structural problems. And a lot of that has actually now been addressed. I mean, there's one good piece of news now, is we've now got a labour market that is much more flexible and able to adjust to a very nasty shock like the one we've got at the moment. Right. Because of those improvements in the supply side some 35 and 40 years ago.
Let me ask you this lastly, Ms. Lightfoot. As an economist, but also someone who's worked as an advisor to the three chancellors, what do you think the optics are? What do you think of the look of ending free parking for NHS staff in England, which was provided during coronavirus? I appreciate it's a relatively new perk, but so soon after we've been applauding them on a Thursday night and recently on a Sunday afternoon, how much sense does it make to you?
In times like this, you don't want some small-minded cheese paring. When you look back to the Great Depression, those countries that engaged in small-minded cheese paring superimposed an irritant factor that really wasn't necessary and wasn't helpful. And I think you need to look to the big issues.
Yes.
To make sure there's the full support for the economy. And in the meantime, you don't want to do the irritant messing about or just annoy people, but also be quite salient as well.
Mr. Lightfoot, thank you. Warwick Lightfoot, you served as special advisor to three chancellors. You're head of economics and social policy at Policy Exchange.